Biophysics graduate student body. Tonight's teams will feature romance versus bromance, old farts versus young guns. Let's introduce our teams. Okay. First, for bromance, we have John Simon and Dave Schuster. Come on. You guys know what you're doing. We're going to demonstrate a little bit here. So Tom and Aaron, or Kieran, sorry, please come up. Just so you guys know what we're looking at, we have a little cheat screen over there, so look at that thing. Awesome. Okay, so we're going to do a quick demonstration of the rules. There are one round for you guys, four rounds for you guys, where you must buzz in to guess the top five responses within a limit of 5 seconds each to guess for each response. The person with the top answer in the first buzzing round will get to go first. Their team gets to go first. You may buzz once I finish reading the question. I guess the first question's already up here, which is, what is the biggest complaint about your PI as voted by the UChicago Physics graduate student body? Go. You're in.
He's not very nice. He's an asshole.
Let's see an asshole! That was a really cool sound, but I guess
I don't know
what's
going on.
For tonight for us. Okay. Tom, you also get a guess.
What if I don't have one?
You don't have a PI?
Yeah, I don't have a PI.
Okay, let's see a non-existent PI! He gets to play. Wait. Okay, Kieran, what is it? What is it, Kieran?
But I got something right. Why does he get to go first?
Yeah, but his response had more responses. There's a higher score value, so he gets to steal the round. Okay, so Tom, you get to play.
What if he's flatulent?
Let's see flatulence.
What if he wears Crocs?
Let's see Crocs!
What if he didn't let me practice for the skits?
You didn't get to practice for the skit? Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Since Tom had three X's, that means Kieran gets a chance to steal the round. If he gets one of the responses left, he takes all the points.
Do I have to buzz?
You can buzz if you like.
He's always on sabbatical?
Let's see absentee professor. All right. Other responses were number two. Unrealistic expectations. And at number five, he is crazy slash spacey. Okay. Now let's get our actual contestants up. You guys take this side. This is your buzzer. You guys take this side. Let's get started with our first round. Question is, faculty member most able to go undercover as a grad student? I think that went to Sid. What's your guess? Our young key, what's your guess? What's your guess?
John Simon.
John Simon. So you guys get to play. who said John Simon? I forgot. Okay, so now you're up. Who do you think? Let's see Sam Sethi. Yeah, so keep going. Do not the buzz, but that's fine.
Ben Holtz.
Let's see Holtz. Let's keep going. Keep going here. She wants hints. Come on, guys. Okay, let's see William Irvin. Okay, keep guessing until you get three X's. Come on.
Abby.
Okay, four. Let's see you sing. 5 seconds. Four. Let's see Schuster. Responses, you get all of the points.
Oh, damn.
Oh, you guys have three X's now.
If they get any of
the remaining answers, they get all of the points. You can buzz. There you go. Okay, yes.
Michael Levin.
Let's see Michael Levin.
Someone was supposed to be in the middle.
Okay. Is it not fair or it's fair? I didn't hear you.
Not fair.
Why is it not fair?
That was our point.
Okay.
Let's move on to the second round here. Broke your buzzers. Okay. Are you guys ready? Faculty member most likely to start and win a bar fight? Dave. No, you buzzed. Oh, you said John. Let's see John Simon. All right. So you guys lost in the chance. If you get round two or three, you need to take the round.
John is going to beat up whoever's
the one. Juan Coyar.
Let's see Juan Coyar. Okay, Sid and Junkie are going to take this round. Three X's means you're out, and it can still afterwards. We already have number two and number four. Okay, so what are your other guesses? 5 second limit.
David Kubasov.
Let's see Kubasov. Okay, what else do you guys got? Come on, 5 seconds. What's going to be next? Give him an X. Okay, you guys want to stay with Paul Feigman?
No.
Okay, 5 seconds. Leo Kutch. Leo Kutch. Okay, keep going, 5 seconds. Okay. 1, 5, 4. Okay, it's here.
Jen Harvey.
Let's see Harvey. Okay. John and Dave. This is your chance to steal on this. You have one guess to have either number three or number five response.
I mean, it's clearly Paul Gateman.
Let's see Pinkman! Alright! Romance wins once more, and they get all the points for this round. Let's go to round three. Oh, God. Okay, let's see round three, let's go. Name a bad trait for an experimentalist to have. John.
A social.
Oh no! You guys know, they don't know. Maybe you know. Okay. So you guys go, you didn't see it. Bad trait for an experimentalist to have.
A social life.
A social life. Let's see a social life. Come on, this is polling you, the students. You guys are guessing what the graduate students say.
What the graduate students say?
Yes. What's a bad trait for an experimentalist to have?
Safety glass.
Okay. I guess you guys need to guess again? This never happened before to me. Come on, guys. This isn't that hard. I know you guys are both great experimentalists, but I mean, what do your students do that you're just like, oh god, why are you here? Or
I wouldn't even told you that.
And you're boost from the crowd. Go on, guys. Let's see if you guess.
How about?
Is this really this hard for you guys? Anyone, just give him a hint. I mean, this is painful.
Clumsiness.
Let's see clumsiness. All right, I'm on the one response. Thank you, Alex.
They should get a second guess.
Oh, so Alex is playing. Since you guys are so bad, Alex, what's your second guess?
Oh, I didn't see the answers. Being a theorist.
Let's see being a theorist. Yes, they give you a head start.
Oh, and we have to get three. Yeah. Despite the fact that he just took one. So we have to get all of them.
Yeah, you have to get all three
guesses
to get all
of them.
Yeah, sure. I can just
laziness.
Laziness. Let's see laziness. Just give it to him. It's unpainful. Forget all laziness. I mean, go.
Stupid.
Oh,
she's stupid.
I'm
not taking
care of it. Okay, is that three X's for them? Okay. So if you guys get what? Or is that just a mess up?
I just need help.
Okay. This is painful, you guys should know this. You could regret students once too. Okay, Yaki, what are you
doing? Theories.
Being a. Wait, no. You just read what was on the screen. Michael, I mean, just take a guess. They drool. Tremors and some answers that didn't make the final cut, having an imagination and not having arms. But I'm not going to keep points on you on that round, that was terrible. Okay, this is our final round, which basically means you guys can't win, but faculty member most likely to have a secret career as a magician. Come on, guys. Oh god. John.
Ed Blucher.
Ed Blucher! Sitting on me, have you guessed?
Sit.
Sit. Sit. Sit. Sit. Sit. Sit. Sit. Sit. What if it were a glass? Who else?
Heinrich.
Let's see Heinrich. All right. As you keep guessing.
William.
Let's see William Irving. I don't know. We'll give you two more. Creating pop collars out of the vacuum. Okay. You guys get to keep going. Let's see Tom Witten. Alright. Hey, you get the last one, you get to take all the points. Who's number three?
Jeff Harvey.
Jeff Harvey, let's see it. Okay, you guys have one more, right? One more.
Leo Kavanaugh.
Who keeps saying that? I don't even know who you are, but... Okay. Come on. 5, 4, 3, 2, let's see Miller! Now, if you guys get this, you get to steal all the points and win all three rounds by a landslide. So who is number three?
I think it's pretty clear that it's Richard Hill.
Let's see Richard Hill! So by a landslide, we have the bromance winning over the romance. Congratulations to John and Dave. Thank you, Sam, for playing. Thank you all for listening. Thank you all for the show.